one.
Hey, Sophie. Can you say hi?
Hi.
Good job. Can you say I love you? Good job. What sound does a cow make?
Moo.
What sound does a sheep make?
Bye.
Good job. You say bye-bye.
Bye.
Good job.
You hello me.
Hello, Miss Yay.
Hello, Mario.
Hello, Miss.
Hello, Mario.
Hello, Miss.
Morning, everyone. Welcome to Kids Church. I'm so excited that you could join us here this morning. This month, we'll be looking at a man in the Bible called Moses. Moses was a man that did so many amazing things for God. And today, we'll be learning about baby Moses. This month's memory verse is Exodus chapter 3, verse 14. God said to Moses, I am who I am. Today, we're going to learn more about the Bible story. We'll make a craft together and we'll get to worship God. First of all, let's get up on our feet and worship God together.
Hi, everybody. My name is David.
And I'm Johnny.
And we're really excited to be able to worship God with you this morning. And our first song we're going to sing is I'm in the Lord's Army. And now for the second song, This Little Light of Mine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine. Let it shine, let it shine. When I go to church, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, when I go to church, I'm gonna let it shine. When I go to church, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
All right, fantastic singing, everybody.
Hi, guys in Kids Kingdom. I'm Simon.
I'm Martina.
I'm Reef, and this is Alice.
And today we're going to look at the story of baby Moses in Exodus chapter 2.
The story of Moses' birth starts in Egypt. Moses was a descendant of Joseph's brother Levi. Joseph and his brothers had many, many children and grandchildren who lived happily in Egypt. Eventually, a new pharaoh came to power who knew nothing of Joseph or all the things he had done for Egypt. The new Pharaoh feared the Israelites because there was a great number of them living in Egypt. So he wanted to put a stop to their prosperity. Pharaoh made the Israelites slaves. He made them work long, hard hours, building up Egyptian cities and building things like the pyramids. The Israelites grew more in number still and in strength, and so Pharaoh decided that no little boy would be allowed to live any more of all the Israelite kids. And that is where Moses' story begins. You see, when Moses was born, his mother saw he was a special baby, and she kept him hidden for 3 months in the house. When she could no longer keep him a secret, she made a little basket and put him in the Nile River among the reeds. Moses' sister stayed to watch what would happen to her baby brother, and soon enough, Pharaoh's daughter came to the edge of the river, and when she saw the basket, she said, "Hey, go get that baby." And she felt sorry for it, thinking it must be an Israelite baby who wasn't supposed to live. Moses' sister asked the princess if she would like her to find Israelite woman to take care of the baby. So Moses and his sister went and got Moses' real mother. And his real mother took care of him until he was old enough to live in Pharaoh's house, where the princess adopted him as her son. And so Moses was an Israelite boy who wasn't supposed to live like the grandson of a Pharaoh, but and lived in the palace as God prepared for him a great destiny and an amazing story to bring Israel out of Egypt. Hi guys, hope you enjoyed the story. As you can see, God can take something really terrible in Moses' situation and turn it into a victory and eventually have lots of people saved.
All right,
bye now.
Hi everyone, so it's time to do crafts. So this is the craft that we'll be making. I hope that you've been enjoying learning about baby Moses and how God takes care of him just like he takes care of you. So this is what it looks like, and you can see that baby Moses is moving down the river, and it says, God has a plan for Moses, God has a plan for you. So let's get started. So this is what you will need for the craft. First, you'll need the printout, a pair of scissors, a popsicle stick, texters, and sticky tape. So you can use texters or crayons or anything that you can find in the house. So first I'm going to color in the craft. So I'll color in the baby Moses and the river. Now I'm going to cut where the dotted line is, and I'm going to start over here. Next, I'm going to cut where the dotted line is over here, and I'm going to start in the middle. Next, I'm going to cut out little baby Moses. So now we're going to use this popsicle stick and we're going to stick it on the back of the baby Moses. So we're going to use sticky tape. And we're going to stick it on the back, like this. Now we're going to put the baby Moses in here where we cut it before. And there you go, baby Moses moving down the river.
Welcome back, everyone. Hope you enjoyed today. Now let's sing one last final song together, and that song is, you guessed it, the Sea of Galilee. So let's all stand and sing. There's a boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are hands in the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are hands in the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are hands in the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are fish in the nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are fish in the nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are fish in the nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are many, many fish in the nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are many, many fish in the nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. There are many, many fish. There are many, many fish. There are many, many fish in the nets in the hands of the men in the boat in the Sea of Galilee. Woohoo! Well done, everyone. Now I hope you all have a fantastic day, and thanks for joining us.